Hey everyone, thanks for joining today. Let me start with a quick question. Who's ever worked on a legacy application and felt trapped by technical debt? At Thomson Reuters, we're working across decades of tech evolution, monoliths, microservices, .NET, Java, and more, all of it mission critical. Managing that environment takes time. And for every hour our teams are applying patches, updating libraries, or managing infrastructure, that's time we're not spending delivering value to our customers. If you know Thomson Reuters solely as the legal research or tax software company, that's fair, but it's only a fraction of the story. Today, Thomson Reuters is building the AI infrastructure that the professional world runs on. We serve over 500,000 customers, from the largest law firms and governments to startups and solo practitioners. We operate at a global scale with over 26,000 employees, 4,000 domain experts, and one of the world's largest trusted content ecosystems. And we're investing over $10 billion to transform how high-stakes work gets done. But here's the truth. Transformation is hard. Like many of you, we were wrestling with legacy code. For us, that meant decades of .NET applications. Critical to our business, but slowing us down and stacking up technical debt. We were asking ourselves the tough questions. Can we move faster without sacrificing trust? Can we modernize at scale, not just with one-off wins? That's why I'm here today, to share what we've learned as we take on one of our most ambitious migrations yet. It's not perfect, and it's not finished, but this is what it looks like when a 160-year-old company decides to move like a startup. Today, we support our customers by running over 70 digital products and managing more than 20 billion documents across legal, tax, and compliance workflows. But here's the challenge. That scale comes with complexity. We've spent the last few years building an incredibly resilient, capable, global technology estate at Thomson Reuters. One of our major accomplishments is that we recently completed our migration of 95% of our workloads to the cloud. In total, over 50,000 servers across 1,000 applications in just 6 years. That move gave us a cleaner, more agile foundation to innovate on. It allows our teams to spend more time working on AI capabilities, but we were still carrying around the legacy .NET code, and that legacy was slowing us down. It wasn't just old, it was competing with innovation. Developers were stuck maintaining unfamiliar legacy frameworks that couldn't be replaced overnight. So we had to modernize while staying fully operational. That was our tension. So we started looking for AI technologies to help us solve this problem. We ended up choosing AWS. Why? For us, it came down to three things: reliability, intelligence, and velocity. We tested multiple modernization approaches. Some worked, but none were built to scale across hundreds of applications. When we got access to AWS Transform, we knew we had something different. It wasn't just another code converter. It was an agentic AI solution that could plan, refactor, validate, and iterate with our team in the loop. One of the first hurdles that AWS Transform solved was supporting the versions of .NET that we needed. Then, we ran into many other challenges. Some transformations started by skipping many of the solution files that we tried to transform. Some ran for days, needing us to re-authenticate just to keep them going. Some of them ended with hundreds or thousands of errors. But we kept iterating, we kept learning and working our way through each one, and it ended up with AWS Transform being the solution that generated fewer errors and handled them more gracefully. Documentation was thorough, clear, and designed for real-world use. And after we stumbled a few times, the success rate on transformations, especially the complex ones, was dramatically higher. We went from months of work to a two-week sprint, modernizing 1.5 million lines of code each month. That's a 4x improvement in speed. And more importantly, it gave our developers time back to build the future, not maintain the past. Now, we're modernizing for many reasons: speed, security, cost, and customer impact. Right now, we're running 7 .NET modernizations in parallel. That's millions of lines of code, not side projects. With Transform as a force multiplier, we're moving safely to production without shutting down or starting over. because companies like ours don't get a greenfield reset, and these transformations don't happen in isolation. So what's the biggest win for our customers? Focus. Our engineers will be able to have the occasional sprint to merge and test upgrades instead of having a small number of resources always focused on that work. They can spend that time solving real customer problems, things that are specific to the legal, tax, and compliance professionals that we serve. It's also about quality and speed. Modern platforms let us ship features faster, adapt to market shifts, and deliver smoother, more integrated experiences across our products. But manual testing in some of these systems slows down how quickly we can validate these AI changes. From a business perspective, every modernization unlocks capacity. Less time on maintenance means more time shipping new features. It also unlocks years of IP in these code bases, allowing us to leverage it in new ways for our customers. And it reduces infrastructure costs. Moving to Linux cuts operating costs for us by 30%. It dramatically reduced technical debt and eliminated risk by removing outdated dependencies. This all rolls up into one thing: greater agility. We can move faster, pivot when needed, and double down where we're finding traction. And we're not done, not even close. We have a handful of transformations done and thousands of .NET repositories to go. So we have a long road ahead, and we're realistic about what AI can and cannot do. This isn't a silver bullet, but that's true of all AI-assisted work. The value comes when you pair it with strong engineering practices. So we're expanding our use of AWS Transform beyond just .NET modernization, using it for ongoing hygiene and critical non-differentiating work. It's about removing friction so teams can focus on solving our customers' hardest problems with clarity and speed. So what did we learn? We learned to start small, then scale, keeping a core group of platform engineers involved to spread lessons learned from modernization to modernization. We learned not to wait for the perfect moment. You'll run into many issues, but your legacy tech won't update itself. We learned that AI isn't replacing your team, it's empowering them. We've been successful because we have the right team with the right skill set using these AI capabilities. Smart leaders understand the real win isn't just faster modernization, it's freeing up your engineers to do their best work. And we learned to make this part of your culture. When tools this powerful emerge, we must rethink how we work, embedding AI into our culture to unlock speed, scale, and smarter decisions. So let me leave you with this. We've learned that continuous modernization isn't a one-time project. It's a core capability. We're building a developer experience where undifferentiated work happens automatically. When a new version of a critical library is released, developers receive a ready-to-review pull request, minimizing time spent on routine updates. So make this automation part of how your organization works. Thank you.